Good morning, Doctor.
And a good morning to you too, Elsa. You look radiant.
Thank you, Doctor.
We haven't been seeing much of you lately, Elsa. You've been missing appointments.
I'm sorry, Doctor. I've been feeling much better.
That's very good to hear. And what has brought about this improvement?
It's the new man in my life. He's convinced me to fight my addiction.
Ah, the policeman from the newspapers. How has he coped with his fall from grace?
He can finally see things from a human perspective, rather than the ivory tower he created for himself. It's making him stronger. It's making me stronger helping him.
You wouldn't make a bad analyst yourself, Elsa. Should we swap seats?
We're both finding we have a lot to live up to.
And what is that?
In my case, Blue. He went through hell along with me and still came out smiling. In Cole's case, his friend, Jack Kelso.
Kelso?
You've heard of him?
No, I just like the sound of his name.
Cole and Jack are working on a case together.
Is Jack a policeman too?
No, he works for the district attorney.
What?
He's a special investigator. I thought you didn't know him.
I have never met the gentleman in question.
He has been looking into Lou's case. Cole thinks it might be linked to some fires he's investigating. You look pale, Doctor.
It's cold in here, Elsa. I think I'll close the window. Why are you looking at me like that, Elsa?
You arranged for Lou to work at Elysian Fields, Doctor.
Your fears are unfounded. I meet many people in my line of work. There are many ways that people can be helped. Finding them work is just one of them.
I don't believe you, Doctor. I've seen you with Monroe at the club.
I'm sorry that you have come to that conclusion, Elsa. I've always so enjoyed our conversation. I can see your future, Elsa. And Cole, the policeman. And Jack, the investigator. It's an unfortunate and grisly end.
I've come to help you, Doctor. To help you cross over. All your sins will be forgiven. The next life.
Gotta be one of these places.
The arsonist's a bug sprayer. He must have worked at one of these joints.
The radio reminds you an ounce of prevention saves many an emergency. Check to make sure your home has a first aid kit for safety.
Thank you.
help you?
How many guys you have working here, Pop?
Who's asking, son?
It could be official or unofficial. Depends on how you want to play it.
You should get to a hospital, son. That arm of yours appears to be letting in daylight.
Save the pity for the other guys. They're the ones who need it. I'm looking for a big cowboy who works pest control. Does he work here?
We don't have anyone like that here.
You sure? I'm not the type of guy you want coming back.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Well, you don't see that every day.
What have you got?
Looks like a drug overdose.
Get away from him, Phelps. This is my case.
Shut your fucking mouth.
Since when does a bag man work a case?
I knew this creep wasn't on the morphine heist. Victim of his own product.
Hey, detective! Can we back it off a notch? This is getting out of hand.
There's a time to talk and a time to shut up. Now is the time to be quiet, son.
Courtney Sheldon was a corpsman, Roy. He served his country. He went out with a medical kit and an Army 45 into places that made the Valley of Death look like a picnic. He was either naive enough or dumb enough to get involved in the Suburban Redevelopment Fund, along with the mayor, the DA, Monroe, and a certain crooked cop. He was involved in the morphine heist, but he has a puncture wound in his jugular, which makes this a murder case. He was a better man than you'll ever know. You say one more word about him, and I will blow your fucking head off!
You finally lost it, partner.
I have a pretty good idea why Sheldon is dead. And I know about Monroe. Your vast, corrupt future is draining away as we speak.
I got better things to do than argue the rub with you.
Stay with him until the coroner gets here. Make sure technical services bags the evidence. If you let this creep anywhere near it, I'll come looking for you.
Yes, sir.
You know, Phelps, you're not the worst asshole going around.
Thanks, Herschel.
Welcome to Nuclear. What can I do you for?
I work for the DA. I need to speak with an exterminator, big guy with a cowboy accent.
We have only three people work here, me and two Mexicans. They're both on the scrawny side.
Thanks for your help.
Well, you don't see that.
There's a story of a roaring mountain town, and a gal who really knew her way around. They still talk of that event, 'cause the way she came and went, she took the town and turned it upside down. With her red hooded stockings and her green perfume, she blew into this man's town with a silver spoon. Never was any trouble, but she started some soon. With her red hooded stockings and her green perfume.
Old town was the red silk stockings and the green perfume. She was singing a love song in a gambling hall. When along came a stranger, he was handsome and tall. He won every last dollar that we had in the room. And the red silk stockings and the green perfume. The red silk stockings and the green perfume.
I work for the DA. I'm looking for a big cowboy who does extermination. Anyone like that working here?
Well, I wouldn't want to get anyone into any trouble.
We could do this the hard way. An address?
Yeah, he lives in a bunkhouse on the remains of the old Rancho Rincon.
Thanks.
Cole, you made it.
What's this got to do with me, Rusty?
Dr. Fontaine, prominent shrink, dead in his patient's room, spine snapped like a twig. The suspect is one of his mental patients.
I've met Fontaine.
His last patient was Elsa Lichtman, Cole. She's missing. Nurse said that she saw some big Boris Karloff type carry her out of here.
The best thing that you can do to help me, Rusty, is let me take a look around.
Sure thing, Cole. This way. Take your time. I'll give you and the doctor some privacy.
Good doctor has been marking this map. Edgewood Grove. McCarthy Vista, Crescent Heights, Rancho Escondido. Do those names mean anything to you, Herschel?
Yeah. How come?
New houses all being built in the path of the freeway?
Yours is burning down our houses.
Keep your voice down, Leland. Control is of the essence.
Keep your voice down? Do you know how much these sons of bitches charge for lunch? Fuck them!
Leland, we will not solve our problems by announcing them to the general public. We only speed ourselves on our way to the gallows.
He's your imbecile, Harlan. Get him under control or get rid of him.
Speaking of which, I've had to dispose of our young medical student. What?
You certainly are a cold character, Harlan.
He has a friend called Kelso who knows all about the development. development on Normandy Avenue.
I know about Kelso.
And you thought it unimportant to inform me.
I thought I could take care of it.
And have you?
No, I haven't.
Kelso works for Benson. Is he reliable?
No, he's totally unreliable. But he has so many pernicious habits, he's got nowhere to run.
Can you take care of Kelso?
Don't push me, Harlan. Get rid of the fruitcake. No longer necessary. I'll take care of Jack Kelso.
Destroyed by a monster of your own creation, Dr. Fontaine. I've heard that story somewhere before. So much for your foresight, Doctor. Monroe wasn't happy. People started dying and it attracted attention. And the doctor lost control. Fontaine was having the houses burned for Monroe. Optimistic, Cole. Like Fontaine has finally dispensed his last treatment. Jack was wrong. It's not about insurance, it's about eminent domain.
What are you talking about, Cole?
The government reclaims the land in the path of the freeway and pays the improved value of the land with the new houses sitting on it.
What about the stiffs who paid their deposits?
Worst case, they get their money back. But the syndicate pockets millions on the improved value of the land.
So where does Jack's boss come into it?
He's the key. He carries the insurance. The insurance proves how much the houses are worth.
And they're worth nothing.
Firewood, all of them.
That's about as neat a scam as you can imagine. How are we going to prove any of this, Cole? Doctor's dead. Monroe nearly bled to death. If they get Jack...
We need the firebug. The Okie cowboy. Get him, get Elsa. Get him, get all of them. Guess nobody's home. Most guys bring home a 45 or an M1. This is pretty extreme. Quite a flock you got here, kid. A strange obsession. The river tunnels. This guy's a tunnel rat. I know those faces. Jesus Christ, I know every one of them. Oh my God, Ira. You poor backwards son of a bitch. Peterson, I'm going to need some help. I've got Monroe, Fontaine, and all the others. It's all tied up nicely. It goes all the way to the top. Meet me at the LA River Tunnel entrance just north of the First Street Bridge in half an hour. Don't ask questions. Just be there. This is DA's investigator Jack Kelso. I have an urgent radio message for Detective Cole Phelps.
KGPL.
11K, see the man. A 207 just occurred on the spillway north of the First Street Bridge. DA's investigator Jack Kelso reports a kidnapping suspect outstanding in the LA River tunnel system with a hostage. 11K and
Roger
code
that.
3.
The hell is Jack playing at? Like a suicide note. Half the LAPD will be down there hunting for us.
We need to get there first.
All units on all frequencies, stand by. Car 86 Adam is in pursuit of suspect vehicle heading southwest on Sunset Boulevard. Suspect vehicle belonging to Jack Kelso, described as a Navy Chevrolet fleet line. License number 4, William 0286. Car 86 Adam is in pursuit.
They picked up his car. I'll need help to make it to the river.
That's Kelso's car.
Suspect vehicle to be disabled immediately. If necessary, use of deadly force is authorized.
Jesus Christ! How many cops do these guys own?
All units. We have a new suspect vehicle. It is shop number 13516. Repeating, shop 13516 is a second suspect vehicle. Described as a green Hudson Commodore. License 3-SAM-0102. Reported to be a suspect, Jack Kelso. Use caution to continue pursuit. All units, stand by for further.
All units, suspect vehicle plan is heading northeast toward 3rd Street on the embankment between 3rd and 4th.
Suspect vehicle, shop 13516. Chief Wall has authorized the use of deadly force. Repeat, use of deadly force is authorized for disabling both suspect vehicles.
This guy?
Peterson, assistant DA.
What's he doing?
He's here to cover our backs.
I'm going in there, Jack.
No one's trying to stop you. I found this at the ranch house. He's marked his routes. I'll go in here. Cole, you take the next entrance. Biggs, I need you to take the car and cover this spot here. I think that's his failsafe exit. Cole, he's one of ours.
What are you talking about?
Right where you are!
Got it. Peterson, you want to be DA? We'll earn your salt.
So, Kelso is your boy, Peterson? And working with Phelps? A handy lad, that Kelso.
Yes, he is, Chief. You can't imagine what those two have uncovered. It could go all the way to the top. I hope you won't be implicated.
So, you're the new groom, Peterson?
Looks like it.
And you think he'll make it out of there alive?
I think he might. He's a difficult boy to get rid of.
All right, Peterson. I'm listening. What's your offer?
Keep on going, Jack.
Let's see if I can.
God damn!
Christ, just missed.
Eyes open. He's around here somewhere.
Throw out the gun. Flesh wound.
Eyes open. It's around here somewhere. Show me your face, motherfucker!
Want me? An inch to the left and you would have had me, boys. How long do you think you can hold out?
Somebody tag that son of a bitch, will ya?
As soon as he pokes his head out, we'll step on.
You're surrounded and your buddies are dead.
Catch a bullet, you...
Thank you.
The water's rising. You could walk out of here or go out in a box. Your choice.
Eyes open. He's around here somewhere.
You want me? You got me.
Are you okay, Princess?
I felt better. He saved me from the doctor.
Hi, Tex. Do you remember me?
I'm not sure that I do. Have you come here to kill her?
Why would I do that, soldier?
Isn't that why you're all here?
I'm here to get her out.
Her. But not me. You haven't come for me.
No, not you. It ends here.
You were with the Sixth on Sugarloaf, weren't you?
I was.
And Nahal?
Yes, I was.
You're Sergeant Jack Kelso, aren't you? Where's your uniform, Sarge?
At home in my locker, Hogaboom. War's over, soldier.
I know that, Sarge. I'm fighting a different kind of war. I fight for God now.
We all fight for God, Ira.
In our own ways. Not everybody knows it.
Elsa! Are you all right? Get away from her!
It's all right, Cole. He doesn't want to hurt her. Ira was with us on Okinawa.
What? You know this guy?
Don't you remember me, Lieutenant? I remember you.
No. Don't.
You ordered me to burn that cave, Lieutenant. That cave full of civilians. A hospital.
What is he talking about?
It was war. For God's sake, I can't be held responsible for everything that happened.
I don't blame you, Lieutenant. You helped me to help other people.
Ira lost his mind on Okinawa, Princess.
Sheldon asked the doctor to help him get back.
The doctor helped me to find my path. And I helped him to a better life.
Elsa's going to leave now, Ira. She will be all right. You've helped her, too. Get her out of here. Biggs will help. His exit is nearby.
Jack, I need this guy to make the case.
Hasn't this poor bastard given you enough? Get out of here now!
For God's sake, Jack! What are you going to do?
Don't cry, miss. Sergeant Kelso has come to help ease my way. I was proud to serve with you, Jack.
Get out of here, Cole!
Stop
the goddamn screaming!
I need to think!
And how do you expect to do that, you fucking maniac? They're burned to a crisp!
Finish them off. Do it humanely. We are leaving this place.
You do it, Phelps! Get your own fucking hands dirty! I'm out of morphine!
Put these people out of their pain. Now! That's an order!
Everyone out of here now.
Double time!
You two get Lieutenant Phelps to an aid station. Weapon team will be blowing this place in 2 minutes. Everything that happened in here stays in here. Do you hear me? I don't want to ever hear another word about it.
He killed that man!
He was doing him a favor, Elsa.
Cole, up here. I'll get this grenade.
Hurry, hurry!
The water's rising.
You're first.
Hand her up.
Get out of here.
You're not here.
I'm not arguing.
You're wounded, Jack.
Let me help.
What are you waiting for?
Jump, Cole. Jump for it.
We're gathered here to honor Detective Cole Phelps. Cole Phelps was the best kind of man.
Hear, hear.
A war hero who led his men with true valor. And through his personal bravery, achieved one of his country's highest honors. A cop wrongly accused who never lost his faith in the LAPD and the system.
Ryan, you belittle his memory.
Elsa.
Get out of my way, Jack. You call yourself his friend.
A detective who fought to expose the evil corruption of the murderous Dr. Fontaine and the rapacious property tycoon Leyland Monroe.
Go to her. Will you, Herschel?
A reformer.
Who recognized
the need to remove the odd bad apple from a department made up of good men.
Herschel?
A man who never gave up.
Yeah, Jack.
Who continued to fight the good fight.
I think you knew that, Jack.
The fight that cost him his own life. A good husband. A good father. And may I say, a good friend.
Thank you.
judge and jury, they all agree. If love's the crime, I'm doing time, and it don't look like I'll ever get free. Yeah, baby, you know I'm guilty. Baby, you know I'm guilty. While you're my Clyde, I'll be your Bonnie. I could pretend I'll be good again, but while loving you's the charge I'll never be. Cause baby, you know I'm guilty. Baby, you know I'm guilty. So lock me up and throw away the key. I don't need no bail. If you're the jail, just give me life and grant me no reprieve. Cause baby, you know this case is closed, and don't suppose I'll make a plea. Cause baby, you know I'm guilty. Well, I need something to soothe this pain, to cool the lava you pump through my veins. Cause I'm burning, I'm burning up for you. And I need something to quench this fire before it becomes a funeral pyre. Yeah, I'm burning with yearning so much for you. You struck the sparks, you fanned the flames in me. And now my heart's a blazing ruin. You say that you were only fooling. Don't walk away. Don't do me wrong. Don't leave me singing this torched song. When I'm burning, I'm burning up for you. And now my heart. heart, a blazing ruin. You say that you were only fooling. Don't walk away. Don't do me wrong. Don't leave me this way, singing this torch song. Don't leave me burning. I'm burning up for you. Well, I love the trade till the minute I win it. A beautiful face delivers love for me in it. Give me your heart, and baby, I'll bill it. 'Cause I always kill the things I love. Some folk would die for the sake of another, lay down their life for their sisters and brothers. For me, sacrifice is something quite other, 'cause I love to kill the things I love. The look in your eyes will turn to surprise as you feel the pain and you realize the one hurt in you is somebody who once said, I love you.
Former 6th Marine hero has been promoted in the LAPD.
No idea.
Well, could be anybody.
You give up?
Tell us or hand over the fucking paper.
The Shadow Boys. Our very own Silver Star winning son of a bitch.
Phelps? He didn't die, Jack.
He did just fine, and that's all we're going to say about it, right?
The one and only. Look at this picture. Golden Boy, getting his badge. Wife and kids in tow and looking awful humble in the process.
Well, he's set.
Phony bastard.
I wonder if they've been holding my job for me after all this time.
What job was that?
Mechanic.
Ain't you seen all the war bond movies, Sarge? All the best mechanics is women. You're gonna have to work as a gigolo from here on in.
I was a bus driver in Santa Cruz. No pictures in the papers or medals for me, though.
I can't believe I just went through Petaluma and Okinawa just to go back to being a washing machine mechanic.
How is it that jerks like Phelps get it all?
It doesn't have to be that way, guys.
What are you talking about? It's always gonna be that way.
Do you have any idea what you guys are sitting on?
Yeah, a ship full of army surplus.
You're sitting on surplus morphine. 2 tons of it. Can you imagine what that's worth on the streets? Hundreds of thousands of dollars.
You're shitting me.
I'm not.
You're talking about stealing it?
Keep your voice down. Do you want to have us all thrown in the brig?
God damn it, Sheldon. You want to go into the dope business?
No. I want to be in the peace dividend business.
What is that supposed to mean?
It means I want the guys who fought for a better future to get some share of it. You interested, Jack?
Come on, Top. We could all get out from under.
Oh, it's the chance of our lives.
It's everyone or no one, boys.
I'm not having a bar of it, Courtney. You may be the bravest person I have ever met, but I swear to God, trouble follows you around like a pet fucking dog. I thought you wanted to try for medical school.
So what do you want, Jack? What's the future got in store for you?
You guys were all heroes in the war. Every single one of you. Even if your next-door neighbor or your wife never know it and don't give a rat's ass. Fuck belts and medals and citations and parades. Fuck the public who are bored with returning GIs. I have nothing but respect for what you guys and the rest of the 6th have done. You go through with this, and you'll be nothing to me.